What exactly are the main issues on the agenda of your organization?
Well, there are a lot of topics that we follow with ICS, International Chamber of Shipping. But amongst all, I think that definitely today the priorities are seafarers, decarbonization, and the free trade. But of course, we are following also safety and security and many other matters that are also important. But probably I would say that the most important of all is seafarers today after the pandemic, because we are living and having a huge shortage of seafarers. This is due also to the war between Ukraine, Russia and Ukraine, and the invasion of Ukraine. And because of that, another 16% of the total seafarers are not available. And this is over 300,000 seafarers. Again, we have the same problem with Filipinos, because EMSA didn't find accurate their certification. So it might be a problem that they will not be allowed on European ships. And also there was a scarcity of seafarers even before. During the pandemic, they had a real nightmare. In some countries, they were not hospitalized. Many of them were not able to go back to their homes after probably a very long period on board of the vessel, sometimes even 1 year. And there was no flight back. So they were sort of prisoners on board of the vessel. So they must have had a real tough time. And certain priorities that they should have received from the states, they have not received, such as one for vaccination and other things. So I think now we have a scarcity of seafarers, and we need to address this, probably proposing even better standard of living on board of the vessel.
Mr. Grimaldi, if you were to make a projection on the future of the industry, what would that be?
I think actually this terrible 2-3 years with pandemic, war, high prices of closed down, all this has demonstrated that the industry is very, very resilient. And therefore, you know, I think the industry will definitely survive. But of course, we have to make also a commitment, a responsible commitment to decarbonize with a pragmatic approach. And I think this is what we need to do. And we need to look, since we are working on unknown territory, even if some technology are emerging, even if some new bunkers are emerging and so on, I think that we have to be careful and leaving the various options available.
Now, are there any specific initiatives that you're actually prioritizing?
Yeah, I think the ICS has a very important initiative. The initiative that we had is to propose at the IMO a new taxation system which would then reward the people who will start and new investment in new technology. So this, I think, it's a very pragmatic and responsible approach, and I hope that is gaining momentum within the IMO, because we cannot address the decarbonization with regional emission trading scheme or something like the European have done, and which would definitely be replicated in other parts of the world, creating overlapping and duplications and an administrative nightmare.